Hi everyone, welcome to Carmen's Australian Storytime. Today I'm reading Big Rain Coming. The author is Katrina Germain and it's illustrated by Bronwyn Bancroft. The reason I love this book is the illustrations. Let's flick to the blurb and see what it tells us about the book. The blurb. This book first caught my eye because of the beautiful drawings. In Australia, we are often waiting for rain, especially over summer. Let's find out if they get the rain they need. Everyone and everything is waiting for the rain. Rosie's kids, the panting dogs, the fat green frogs, dogs, frogs, and old Stephen. I wonder who he is. For he predicts its arrival. If you predict something, that means you know that it's coming and you tell everyone about it before it's even happened. But when will the big rain come? On Sunday afternoon, old Stephen nodded to the dark clouds spreading in the south. What do you know about clouds? When clouds are big and dark, they are full of rain. We call them cumulus nimbus clouds or rain clouds. Cumulus means to accumulate, to get lots of things, and nimbus means rain. The clouds are starting to fill up the sky. In outback Australia, it is hot and dry for very long periods of time. We call this drought. Big rain coming, he said. I wonder if old Stephen's right. But on Monday, there was no rain. I have heard the days Sunday and Monday so far. What day do you think will be next? Do you know your days of the week? The night was so warm. Rosie's kids dragged their beds outside to maybe feel some breeze while they slept. Making connections. Wow, have you ever dragged your mattress outside to sleep? I have once before with my two children, but we couldn't sleep because we kept being bitten by mosquitoes, little tiny insects that bite and make a lot of noise, especially at night. So we didn't get to stay outside to experience the nice cool breeze. Have you ever camped out at night and looked up at the stars? On Tuesday, there was still no rain. It's Tuesday. Oh no, where have the rain clouds gone? In the northern parts of Australia, the rain clouds build and build and build. We call it the build-up. It is hot, humid and sticky. What day is coming next? The panting dogs at Roberta's camp dug themselves dusty holes to keep cool. Activating your prior knowledge. If the dogs are panting, what do you think they need? I know when my dog's panting, it means she's hot and it usually means she's trying to get cool and she might need some water. Why do you think the dogs are digging holes to keep cool? Well, if you know about animals, they often dig holes in the ground because as you scratch the surface of the ground, it'll get cooler and cooler the further down you go. Good idea, dogs. Wednesday came and still no rain. It's Wednesday, still no rain. Do you think old Stephen was right? What day will be next? The children swam in the billabong after school. The water was warm and still. What is a billabong? In Wiradjuri Aboriginal language, the word is billabang and means lake. It is usually the water that is left behind when a river changes its course. Do you think the children will enjoy swimming in the water if it is warm and still? Usually we go for a swim to cool off. Do you think it's going to be very refreshing if it's warm and still? By Thursday night, there was still no rain. It's Thursday? Oh boy, still no rain. Are you sure it is coming, old Stephen? We are coming to the end of the week. We've had Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and now Thursday. What day is next? The fat, green frogs huddled around the leaky tap on the rainwater tank. What a great way to describe those frogs. They do look fat and green. Why do you think the frogs are hanging around the leaky tap? Do you think having a rain tank is a good idea? I still don't see those rain clouds. I'm thinking about what I know about frogs, and they like to be near water, so I'm guessing that's why they're hanging around that leaky tap so they can have a drink. I also think tanks are a great idea if you want to store some water during a drought. Then, on Friday evening, the thick grey clouds over the hills were echoing with thunder. It's Friday! Old Stephen was right. The rain clouds have returned, covering the sky. Have you ever been in a big thunderstorm? What did it sound like? Did you have echoing thunder? Now I think it will definitely rain. I can't see any blue sky anymore. Those clouds look like they are full of rain. Big rain coming, said Stephen. In Aboriginal culture, the older members of the community are called elders. Everyone respects them and listens to them as they pass on culture and knowledge to the next generation. Do you have older people in your family who pass on to you your family's culture and knowledge? But there was still no rain. Oh no, still no rain? Do you think they trusted old Stephen? He was their elder. Sometimes we have to be patient and wait for things. Can you think of a time you had to be patient and wait for something? On Saturday, there was rain. It's Saturday and it's raining. Everyone looks happy and they are dancing in the rain. Old Stephen was right. He knew and his prediction came true. Have you ever played in the rain? I have. In fact, I did it yesterday at the beach with my dog and we had a great time running around in the ocean and in the rain. Wonderful, cool, wet rain. Everyone is enjoying the rain. They are all using adjectives to describe the rain. What other words could you use? I thought of refreshing, beautiful, heavy, amazing. Usually when the big rains come after a build-up, it can rain for days and days and the rain is very heavy rain. But you know what? You can still play in it because the rain is warm. It cools you down, but it's also warm, so it's very fun to play in. I wonder if you can remember all of the days of the week that we just talked about. And I wonder if you could do a retell of this book. What happened on Sunday? And then what was happening by Wednesday? And then what happened at the end of the book on Saturday? Thanks for listening to Big Rain Coming. Why don't you have a go at drawing some big thunderclouds and rain? Please comment and subscribe, and I look forward to our next book. Thanks so much for listening.